Hello and welcome to this special show on Bloomberg Quint. While NBFCs have been on a tear in the recent times, the same cannot be said for Muthoot Finance. India's largest gold finance company in terms of loan portfolio has seen the returns, negative returns through the last year. What are the prospects ahead for the company? Let's ask the Managing Director, George Alexander Muthoot. Sir, thank you for joining us on Bloomberg Quint. Very good morning, sir. How would you describe your gold finance business? Are we seeing some improvement in demand? As in the last 4-5 years, the gold loan AUM has nearly remained unchanged.
Yeah, in the last 4-5 months, we are seeing better traction in gold loans. I think the reason can be attributed to better economic activities and the demand. It's in the last 4-5 months, we have seen better traction, and we would see the improved results in this quarter, definitely.
All right, sir. The last time you saw a double-digit growth rate in credit was in Q4 of FY17. What is your estimate, and when can we see a double-digit growth going ahead?
Yeah, see, from our feeling, from what expectations we have now, I think this year, I'm sure that this year, while we end the financial year, we should see 15% plus growth in the gold loan portfolio.
Well, talking about asset quality, gross NPAs are at multi-quarter highs, almost 7% for Q4 of FY18. What kind of guidance are you working with, and what's the visibility you have in terms of the recovery?
See, what we see is, you should understand something special about the gold loan NBFCs. As far as gold loan NBFCs are concerned, there is no NPA which results in a loss to the company. Whatever NPA you say are just technical NPAs which have crossed the threshold time limit. But as a gold financing NBFC, we have the full gold with us, where we can realize the principal as well as the interest. It is just that we are giving more time to the customer to take back his gold instead of having to auction it. That is why you see NPAs. In the last 15, 20 years of our working in this company, we have not lost even 1 rupee because of an NPA. The NPA will never result in a loss for a gold loan company. And whatever NPS which you 7%, 8% which you saw in the last quarter, as we are speaking, 75 to 80% of it is already out of our books. And by the end of the quarter, a big chunk will go away and a new set of numbers will come. So I think it is time that industry, everybody, all the rating agencies, etc., understands it, that gold loan NBFCs does not have any problem with an NPA. It's only a technical NPA. We never lose money on an NPA.
Sir, also, what kind of growth outlook are you working for your other subsidiaries, say housing finance, microfinance, etc.? Also, how do you plan to fund these businesses?
Yeah, today the housing, the gold loan portfolio was about 28,500 last year. And the other portfolios together was about 3,000 crores. That means 90% of our total book was gold loan and 10% was other businesses. So next year, by the end of this year, we would like this to become 85% gold loan and 15% of other products. In the other products, the one which is growing very well now is the housing finance, which is an affordable housing finance. So the AUM at the end of last year was 1,450 crores. And this year we should see it end up with an AUM outstanding of 2,900 to 3,000 crores. And the microfinance, which is the other one, is a 100% subsidiary. Microfinance is a 65% subsidiary. And that we see we have an AUM of 1,100 crores as of last year, which the company expects to reach again 1,900 crores by the end of this year. We also have started a very small book on personal loan, which is loans to salaried customers, which is very, very small now, maybe just 25 crores. But probably by the end of the year, we should have about 200 to 250 crores of this book also. Now, your question about how we are planning to fund this, Muthoot Finance has a very good capital base. We have almost a 37% of net worth, which is very, very good for the company, and we have a lot of headroom for funding this. Of course, bank funding is also there. We don't expect any difficulty or substantial difficulty in getting bank funding or also the NCDs.
All right. Also, if you could give us a sense in terms of your NPA trends, so within the MFI business and in the home loan business separately.
In home loan business, in both these businesses, we keep a track on the industry, and the NPAs are much below the industry level. In home finance, it is less than 0.5%. Less than 0.5%, and in the microfinance, it is again less than 1%. One advantage which the microfinance company which we are running has is that it is giving most of these loans to SH group instead of the JLR group. So it's not joint liability, which is the bigger part of the business. It is the STH, which is actually much better, and it has a little more vintage before a customer takes a microfinance loan. So both these, we have been able to keep the NPAs to below industry levels.
Right, and so my last question to you is, what about your lending rate? Would you be looking to bring it down as the cost of funds has come down substantially as you compare it to last 2-3 quarters?
The cost of funds has come down in the last 4 quarters, and we actually have got about 150 to 200 basis points of advantage because of that. And we try to maintain our net interest margin in the range of 9 and 10%. So sometimes it goes above 10, sometimes 9%. So going forward also, we would like to keep our net interest margin at this 9 to 10% levels. So if the cost of borrowings goes up or down, we would certainly tweak some of our lending rates also. Probably it will help us to get little more better customers or more customers. So it's a ongoing process where we tweak the rates as it evolves, especially with regard to the borrowing cost.
All right, sir. It was pleasure speaking to you. Thank you for speaking to Bloomberg Quint. With that, it's a wrap on this special show. For more news and updates, stay tuned to Bloomberg Quint.